Hey, I'm Kat Cunning. Thanks for watching Hollywire.
Hey, Hollywire. Just hanging out with my girl, Kat Cunning.
What's up?
That was wow.
We're gonna play Holly Words.
Astrology sign.
I am a...
Who's Sag?
Scorpio.
I was like, oh, I'm Sag.
No, no, my father is a Sag. He's a very good guy.
Weird, is that weird food combinations?
My grandma used to let me eat jalapeno chips with a side of Cool Whip. It's amazing, it cools you off, okay? I know we're like in a phase of being really into healthy stuff, but in the 50s, if you saw that your food came with xylitol, that was like, that made it better, you know?
Dream car.
White Jeep, because I was raised on Clueless.
Woo! Love that movie. I want to know about the show.
Being kleptomaniacs is the main scenario that brings all these people together that otherwise would not be friends.
Yeah.
So it's basically an awesome format for like the popular girl, the nerdy girl, the rebel chick to all become sincerely close with each other.
Are you like your character on the show?
They definitely wanted me to bring me to this character. It was like both really fun and difficult to be you but not you, you know what I mean?
For sure.
Like it's almost
sure.
easier to be like a hardcore character from a different era or with a different accent than it is to be like parts of who you are in an alternate reality.
If you could steal anyone's closet, celebrity, friend, mom, sister, who would it be?
First thing to come to mind is Janelle Monáe. I've been really influenced by her since I was very young. I learned how to do that same like bouffant French twist and it was my go-to for a long time. Having love curly that. Hair, it was like a very incredible answer. And then also just like the tux and one look forever. I've worn these pants probably to every press event this month and I usually wear the same costume on stage for like a whole year and Janelle Monáe is the person who made me feel that I was allowed to do that because she wore a tux for like 8 years in a row.
Your music video concepts are like so bomb. I was like, this chick is so cool. Do you concept all of this yourself? Are you the biggest creative director behind it all?
Totally, yes. My first music video, Wild Poppies, I found this awesome cinematographer that had just like taken photos of me during a gig and I was like, these are really cinematic. Let's make a video. I'm gonna tell you exactly what I want. And they were down, which was really lucky. And then since then, you know, I've been trying to be more and more open to other people's concepts and being a better collaborator. But to be honest, like after years of theater and like being exposed to really cool, like light and set concepts that can just like change the game of music videos where you see the same thing happen over and over again, I get really, really excited about that part of the platform. And when I write the songs, I'm thinking really visually and about the story I wanna tell and the place I wanna take people. And ultimately, I want the things that happen in these videos to happen on huge, like, stages. Like, I want to play the Super Bowl, you know what I mean? But until then, it's a cool way to illustrate, like, what my aesthetic is and where I want to take people.
Okay, we're going to play one more game before we let you go. Rapid fire questions.
Oh, God.
Book or movie?
Movie.
Do you have any hidden talents?
I can do the Star Trek sign with my toes. Like this, but with my toes.
That's
also, I can whistle in such a way that people don't know that I'm whistling.
Do it.
I'm gonna do it for you. Like, who's doing that?
That's
you know, like,
cool.
It's a smile whistle.
First date advice.
I feel like really be who you are actually. And don't try to be perfect or hold back. Like, I would way rather go up to a girl and be like, I would love to go to bed with you tonight. And have her be like, you're a f***ing pervert. Then be like, hey, maybe we should go to 5 dinners and then spend 2 years dating and then find out who we are in 3 years.
Right.
Just like be upfront. Yeah.
Pineapple on your pizza?
No. No.
Something you are really bad at. I feel like you're so good at everything. So
I can't cook.
First thing you do in the morning?
I'm a freak. I put my shoes on when I'm naked.
That is so weird.
Yeah, it just makes me feel like I'm in my day and I should
shoes first.
Sneakers.
Sneakers.
I would never put heels on in the morning, like I'm not totally crazy, okay?
First concert.
Oh, Shaggy at Z100 with my dad.
That's amazing.
Yeah, I was inappropriate. I was very young.
But birds, tell me about birds. How do birds come into the universe.
It really was like the last day of a writing trip in London, like gloomy London. I had tried my best to write hits the whole trip, and then I walked in to the studio, and it was like a home studio. And I just started singing the chorus for Birds, and it sounded sort of like a lullaby. And then I was like, no, I want something really intense in here. And then it turned into like this dark but weirdly sweet ballad. And like every time that I perform that song live, like it gets a round of applause somewhere in the middle or whatever. And I just think it's a magical song because it's so shrouded in metaphor that people hear whatever they want.
For sure. Very, very cool. On that note, make sure you listen to Birds if you haven't already, and be sure to watch her new Netflix show called Trinkets. For more, keep it right here on Hollywire. Bye.